Hello everyone, welcome to our new tutorial which is about extreme value theorem. So in FRM the scope is only the overview, but we will go through some of the examples so that it builds your understanding and not just only the theory. So as you see, basically what this diagram says is you're trying to enlarge a part of a well-defined distribution and try to study it. So basically that's what exactly the extreme value theorem is. So you are only concerned with understanding the extreme values or a very small part of this distribution in a very high detail. So let's start with small introduction or small recap rather to a central tendency theorem. We have taken a standard normal distribution. So as per this normal distribution, so generally these distributions are defined by four moments, which is starting with mean and variance, and any normal distribution is fully explained by these two moments. In statistical term it is called as moments, or you can simply say the four properties or four characteristics of a distribution. So characteristic one or moment one basically means average. So since this is a standard normal distribution, we have taken zero as the mean. Okay, it shows the exactly the center of the distribution. Variance is basically the width or the deviation, so it says how far your data is distributed from the mean. So that's what the variance is. So this you can say 1.5 variance or deviations, this you can say 2.5 deviations, 3 deviations, and so on. So normal distribution gets defined by only these two things. The third moment is skewness, which says whether the data is more on the left side or on the right side. Since this is a standard normal distribution, its skewness is zero, which means it is symmetrical along its center. So exactly the same number of data points lies on the left side as on the right side. Then is kurtosis. This is where the extreme value theorem basically comes into picture. The moment 4 basically describes the heaviness of the tail or how many values there are present in the tail. To read this, so basically there are three things here. So in a single distribution, this is a single distribution, bulk of it is perfectly explained by central tendency. Okay, so this one is completely explained by central tendency. The problem where EVT or the extreme value theorem is needed is in studying these LFHS events. What exactly is LFHS? So it means the low frequency but high severity events. So it's very important to read these and study these events in financial risk management, because these are the ones that can even lead to bankruptcy. These are events which very rarely happen, but when they happen, it could lead to bankruptcy. So 2008 crisis was one such LFHS event. Now EVT or the extreme value theorem is basically a branch of applied statistics which helps us address the problem of these extreme outcomes. Problem in a sense, it helps us read this extreme events in much more detail. It provides us the framework. So if you try to visualize, there's just one distribution and under it basically you are dividing it into a parent and a children distribution. So your central tendency is the parent distribution, which describes your most of the losses. But then there could be some extreme losses which are defined by a child distribution, which we are calling as extreme value theorem. So how do these extreme events are defined by extreme value theorem? There are two ways. One is generalized extreme value theorem, and then another is peak over thresholds. So we'll go through both of these. We'll start with generalized extreme value theorem, GEV, and see how this defines the extreme value. So let's say this is our data for 21 days, where loss on day 1 was 220, and similarly loss on day 2 was 180, and so on. So when we draw a scattered chart, this is how it looks like. Now if you see, what we have done is we've divided this into blocks of 3 days each. 0 to 3 days, 3 to 6 days, 6 to 9 days, 9 to 12, 15, 18, 21 and 24. For each block, we have picked up the maximum value in that block. Okay. So that's how extremes are defined in extreme value theorem. So if you see on here, you have these blocks, and in each block you have these three days, and the losses on these days, and then you select the maximas of those. So for example, in block 1 you have day 1 with 220, let's say, $1 million loss, day 2 with $180 million loss, and day 3 with $120 million loss. So the maximum loss in that bucket is 220. Similarly, maximum loss in bucket 2 is 811. Now you take all these maximums and you draw a distribution. So that's basically what the distribution of max losses or generalized extreme value theorem is. So that's how generalized extreme value theorem defines the maximum loss or the extreme event. So what you do is, essentially, if you see, this is nothing but just the sampling. So from the total data, you pick out some samples. From those samples, you draw a distribution of their means. Instead of that, you are again drawing the samples. Here the sample is defined as each 3 days each, and then instead of average, you are taking the maximum value of it to say that these are my extremes, and then you get your distribution. So this is basically the formula that can help you get the extreme value. You will need to remember these formulas. So essentially it has only three parameters. Two of these are very well known to you guys: mu, which is mean, and then sigma, which is standard deviation. Only one that is new here is eta, and eta is basically defining heaviness of the tail. If eta is greater than 0, then tails are heavier than your normal distribution. If eta is equal to 0, then tails are as good as your normal distribution. If eta is less than 0, then tails are even lighter than the normal distribution. So this is something that you will have to remember. But what is happening behind this formula is this methodology. Okay. So instead of using this methodology, you can simply apply the formula. Now, the another way of defining extreme values is another very intuitive thing, where you define a threshold. Anything above that threshold, you are saying it as an extreme value. Anything below that threshold is not extreme. So we are using the same data again, and we have drawn this line here at 700. Let's say it is $700 or pound or whatever. So any losses above this 700 is considered as extreme value. So here you get 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 values. So we are left with only 5 values when we divide this graph at 700. Now considering that 700 is our threshold, so which is quite normal. You don't have lot of data to play with when you are doing extreme value analysis. So again, you get the maximum values and you draw a distribution of it, and you again get a distribution. So this is how peak over threshold defines the extreme values. So we'll come, you have to remember this formula again as well. We'll try to explain what exactly this formula is, but again this needs to be remembered. So what we are saying is, so your cumulative function, when you have read the probabilities, is basically defined as cumulative function y f of y is equal to probability of x where x is less than equal to y. So what it says is, if you are, let's say take an example, good old example of number of balls, let's say probability of 6 black balls in the box is equal to probability of 1 black ball plus probability of 2 black balls plus 3 plus 4 plus 5 plus 6, but not greater than 6. So that's what it says. A cumulative, this is how the traditional cumulative distribution function is read, where f of y is equal to p of x. Now, to modify this for extreme value theorem, this one, this gets changed. Let's say we call it as f u of y, where u is the threshold. So you see in this diagram, this is u, it is representing the threshold. So we are only interested as part of EVT is this child distribution and not the entire distribution. So this formula, where probability of x minus u, x becomes x minus u, and it again has to be less than y, and with a conditional probability that x needs to be greater than threshold. Okay, so that's how this formula comes into picture to divide this entire distribution into two parts and then study only the child distribution on the condition that x exceed the threshold. So this is that formula. You will need to remember this, but that's how it functions. So this is all about the extreme value theorem. That's in it's a very high level explanation that is in the syllabus. It's more of an overview rather than in depth. So that's why we have kept this video very short, and then we'll see you in the next tutorial. Till then, thank you and all the best.